What does black and blue mean?
How I feel after Grand Lake.
Yeah, how my body feels after this year. This series is called Black and Blue, and for good reason. You know, we're out here chasing the black trophies, and we're not able to get to those blue trophies unless we accomplish getting those black ones, having a good year, making that Elite Series.
So the other thing with black and blue is it is a good reminder of the ups and downs that this sport has. You're gonna get beat up sometimes, you're gonna end up black and blue. Grand Lake just did it to us here, but you gotta get back up and keep coming after it. Nobody's ever made it to the top of this sport without taking their licks. So Grand Lake is kind of up in northeastern Oklahoma, and I live in eastern Kansas, so this is only really a couple of hours from my house, but I don't have a lot of time out here. Especially in the fall, this is really the first, this NPFL and now this Bassmaster Open are the first two fall tournaments I've ever been out here before, so I'm really trying to learn on the fly. I do have maybe 50 or 60 days out here in the springtime, and it is one of the best lakes in the country when the conditions line up in the spring. I've had multiple hundred fish days out here, you know, just phenomenal fishing when it lines up, but this lake's been beat up all year by massive 200-300 boat tournaments just constantly, and this time of year when the fish are spread out late summer and they've been beat up like this, it can be really tough to get a bite, so we're just gonna have to try to figure it out.
Going into practice, I'm gonna do a lot of what I did during the NPFL. Obviously, as everybody knows, it was one-off flipping dock, so I'm gonna concentrate a lot on docks, hopefully find that magical dock, and just cover a lot of water and try to figure out where I get a few bites.
Ready?
First bass of the morning. Multiple bites on a buzzbait now. I think they're all been pretty good ones too. So got a little something we could try one of the mornings, but these right here are gold right now. These 2.5 to 2.75, 5 of those a day, you can probably win the tournament. It's been real tough. That's a Grand Lake beauty out of Ketchum Creek. Down here, Ketchum.
Grand Lake has been one doing a bunch of different things. You can go out and fish offshore and fish crankbaits on brush piles, or you can go up on docks, you can flip jigs, throw spinner baits, and throw topwater.
So here's kind of the structure that we have to deal with out here. Massive amounts of man-made docks. They're everywhere. It's one of the key elements in every tournament. There's a lot of different types of rock, like pea gravel or slate. You know, then you've got offshore structure like foundations, brush piles, and other things like that. And then you've got a little bit of shallow wood. The water is a little bit low, so there's very little wood in the water. You know, we're 5-6 feet short right now of pool where you would actually have willow trees and wood in the water and be a big factor. So right now it's docks, rocks, a little bit of offshore structure. So kind of fishing down the lower end, a lot cleaner water. Sam got quite a few bites today on a spinner bait right behind me. I caught a few on just a regular swim bait. So key baits that we've got so far, just kind of power fishing, cranking, spinner bait, you know, a little bit with a jig, but a buzz bait in the morning. So those are some key things. I get to power fish for a change. I'm pretty excited. I'll mix in a little finesse fishing when the sun gets up high, but for the most part, get to power fish a lot. It should be a lot of fun.
We're rigged, we're ready. The final stop of the Bassmaster Opens for 2021. We're at Grand Lake, and Grand Lake's always treated me good. I fished a FLW tour here, had a good finish there, got a check in the NPFL a couple weeks ago. I'm excited to get out here. You know, there's not a lot of pressure out here this week. I'm not in the running for the Bassmaster Elite Series this year. We're just gonna go out, have fun this week, and hopefully we can, you know, run into some big ones. Grand Lake, Oklahoma, the last Bassmaster Open of the 2021 season starts in 3, 2, 1.
morning, everybody, out here staging at Grand Lake again. Man, these people out here do a great job of getting us in and out of the water. This is a really cool facility here at Wolf Creek. So we're ready to go catch a bass. We're an early boat, about 49, and have a really short day, which, you know, in these tough conditions can kind of be a little bit of a negative. So gonna have to, you know, scrape down, try and figure out how to get between 3 and 5 bites today and hope they weigh a lot. Put myself in contention here. So I think maybe 15 a day is probably gonna win. Maybe a hair more, but it's fishing tough, and that's a big opportunity to go out and try and catch some fish.
Got you, Jim. 49, Greg Mansfield, behind the bass cat. Boat fishy, Cody Schrott. Come here, yes! That's what I'm talking about. Just jump fishing, baby. Number 2. Oh, big son.
Touches right there. It's touching the line.
Another rough day on Grand Lake, man. This lake, this late summer deal has not been good to me. I've had a lot of fun here in the spring, but I've never really figured out how to catch consistent bags out here in this late summer thing. So I did had the bites today to do well again. It's kind of been a struggle for me this year with putting fish in the boat. I had probably between 4 and 5.5 pound largemouth come off a shallow brush pile that I found today, and got a good hook set into it, and just come off as it was pulling by the side of the boat. So could have used that one. That would have had me right up there. But we're gonna be sitting around, I don't know, 60 or 70th place by the end of the day. If I have a good day tomorrow, we could still be there. So I'm gonna try to kind of run opposite of what I did today and see if it works out any better tomorrow.
Day one is wrapped. Worst day of fishing I've ever had, I think. I weighed in one bass, had a 1 pound penalty, and I ended up with 9 ounces today. So very, very disappointed. You know, I really thought I was gonna go out, and I had a pretty good practice. You know, I was getting a bunch of bites, and I don't know what happened. I just went and did the same thing. I went and flipped a lot of docks with a jig, and just never came up with any keepers, and just got on a bad rotation. It seemed like everywhere I ran, there was boats in front of me, or, you know, boats behind the areas I wanted to go, and I wasn't gonna cut them off. So I just kind of ran around and just couldn't get anything going. It's just not a good day. So tomorrow we're gonna regroup, and we're gonna go out and hopefully go, I'm definitely gonna go fish new water. I got so many waypoints out here, and, you know, we're gonna go switch it up, and hopefully we can run into 5.
So the game plan day one was to run a lot of water, you know, sample some brush, fish some docks, stay shallow most of the day. And I'm basically gonna do the same thing tomorrow. I think I'm just, instead of starting down by the dam, I'm just gonna start up around the ramp and kind of stick around the dirty water and crank around a little more, really fish shallow hard, you know, all morning long. I ran down by the dam to fish a buzzbait today, fishing around for an hour after getting 5 bites the last day of practice. I got 0 today, not even a sniff. So we're gonna stick around the ramp and see what happens.
Greg Mansfield, 157, got you, Greg. Jim Diller, 158.
Yep,
okay, come on through, Joel Willert.
That'll go 14. He's touching the line.
Good to me.
He's touching the line.
Yep.
There's one shallow.
Yay!
Well, it's been a pretty tough morning. We're catching ones like that, so I don't know. We'll have to see what happens here.
Sir.
I knew that always. I've caught one there in that corner every single time. Number 4 all day long. Number 4.
Oh, I've just seen 3 fish eat bait along this bank. Let's see if we can get one to bite.
Sounds good.
There he is.
Got him.
Cool. Good one?
Nope.
called my shot though.
Getting bigger.
Like 13.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, come here. Oh my gosh.
You
feel like a bacon.
Got it?
Oh, missed the big one on this dock.
Come on, got it.
Is it a whitey?
Yeah.
No.
No.
It's a keeper.
Number would be number two. Number one.
Yay!
We captured one!
Oh, it doesn't feel little. It is little.
So the pattern is right at the point.
Huh?
The pattern.
Yeah. Little shorty.
Alright man, it's just been, Grand Lakes kind of got my number. Another large year at the boat here, little 12 incher. It's been tough. Still got a little bit of time left, but you know, kind of got my number this week. So this season we had a lot of highs and then we had a few lows. Grand Lake is going to be one of those lows. You know, I've never really figured out this end of the summer transition where it's not quite fall yet and it's late summer and the fishing's tough. I just really haven't figured out what to do in this time period. My results the last 2 years have shown it, so gonna have to get that figured out. But Grand Lake's over, not one of our best events, but you know, still gonna learn something, like Joel was saying earlier, and be ready for next time we come here.
So 2021 open season is done, and you know, we got so many people to thank, man. It's just, it wouldn't be possible with all the great companies that we have helping us out and keeping us going, and you know, giving us the best gear and the best rods, reels, all, you know, just everything that puts us out in good position out on the water. So, you know, we just want to thank everybody. Thank you guys for subscribing. Thank you for tuning in, watching every episode. It really means a lot to us. We appreciate it. And we're going to come back strong again next year.
So like Joel was saying, there's just so many people to thank. We have a lot of people that helped us with the media. Abby, Sam, Brock, all you guys, thank you so much for the help this year. All the people that tuned in, like Joel was saying. But again, thank you to so many people for letting us chase our dream out here, including our families and friends. And Black and Blue season 2 is done. Till we see it again. I swear to God that it might just be the death of me. Just count the reasons why I'm crazy, yeah, it's stressing me. I'm burning pictures of myself like it could set me free. But I can't stop me cause I'm